This video is sponsored by the brand new JV Jiu-Jitsu online store at jvjiujitsu.bigcartel.com. What's going on, everybody? This is Javi Vasquez. Understanding how to maintain a safe distance is a crucial skill that should be learned by all Jiu-Jitsu and MMA practitioners. There are multiple tools used to maintain distance. The primary tool in moving backwards is fundamental footwork and understanding angles, keeping yourself out of corners. Keeping your back off of any object that might prevent you from moving backwards is our objective. A secondary tool that can be used in order to maintain range is the jab. The jab is not simply a punch that is thrown on a whim. It is best used when you understand when and how to throw it. The best time to throw a jab in order to maintain range is when an opponent starts to step towards you. In this video, I'll discuss how to keep yourself from being backed up into a corner utilizing one of my favorite weapons in the stand-up fighting, the jab. Okay, so I'm gonna start to level the playing field a little bit, because who has the advantage in that last scenario where I am pushing? Who has the advantage? The guy pushing. Sorry. Why? Because the only tool that I've given him to go backwards are his feet. I'm gonna add another tool to complicate matters for the guy going forward, to at the very least give him something to think about. So I'm going to push him, I'm going to give him a weapon here. So right now, all he's got, right, distance, all he's got right now are his feet. So anytime I close the distance or want to close the distance by pressing, I can. There's nothing stopping me from doing that. So what we're going to do is we're going to give him an additional tool called the jab. So if Ruben is trying to walk me down, boom, 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 boom. Who's in control now? Now I am the one that's managing that room, so if he wants to close distance, I'm gonna hit him. So throwing a jab, you can get into all the technicalities of cover your shoulder, turn the thumb over, you can get into all of that. That's great. But it doesn't matter, none of that really matters unless you know when to throw a jab. You must understand when to throw. Not so much how to throw, we're aiming it at his face. You don't want to open the elbow, you want to keep the elbow down and you just want to throw it straight from the cannon. Straight. It camouflages the punch. If I'm throwing a jab and I open the elbow, he sees it coming earlier. If I throw a jab from here, boom, it's in. You can't see it. It's one thing. That's about as technical as I get with that jab. Just make sure I just throw it super straight. One thing. The second thing is when to throw. Now, when you throw a jab is the second I see him come forward, I cut him off by stepping forward. Because in order for him to hit me, he's got to step, throw the punch, go, 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 boom, and land. So he's got to step, plant, and then throw. Can't do it at the same time or it's going to, you know, not generate any real power. So as he steps, I also step, but I'm also throwing because I know that, I know when the punch is going. So the second he steps in, boom. Second he steps in, boom. Second he steps in, boom. It keeps him at range. How many times do I throw it until he decides that getting hit in the head is not a good idea and he backs off, go ahead, back up, and now I have space to move. He wants to re-engage, re-engage, boom, re-engage, boom, re-engage, boom, boom. I'm the one that's controlling. Notice he stops moving forward. I am training him with conditional response. Every time he tapped me, I'm gonna zap you. Touch it again. Touch it again. After a while, you stop touching. This is what I want. As he steps into me, boom, I hit him. Step into me, boom, I hit him. Step into me, boom. When am I throwing the jab? Am I going forward to throw the jab? I'm waiting for step in. Boom. Don't step in. Don't step in. Don't step in. I'm not throwing unless he says, now step in. Boom. So all I'm doing is I'm waiting for that moment of time. I'm keeping range. I'm outside the magnetic field. You want to come into the magnetic field? Come in. Come in. Come in. Boom. And keep him outside the magnetic field. It's like a, your jab is an invisible barrier. Not invisible. It's very physical. But you understand what I'm saying? It's invisible because you're not seeing it until you see it. Now that distance, come closer, 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 closer. He's got to get past that distance. Make sense? He's got to get past that distance. So now, same drill, you're trying to trap and throw the hook. The guy going backwards uses the jab. Jab going backwards should neutralize that hook. So you should, it should be real tough to land that hook now. Because the jab will kind of protect you. It's a barrier between them trapping you and you being trapped. Okay, question. Go.
Hey everybody, thank you so much for watching my video. Please click like and subscribe to my channel for more great strike-based jiu-jitsu content. If you have any questions about the techniques that I'm demonstrating, please leave a comment in the comment section below. Thank you so much.